Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about a new feature which came in Summer 24 release and it's called Apex Cursors. So with this new feature, you can really improve your SQL performance when dealing with a large amount of data. So without any more delay, let's understand this powerful feature in detail. So what is Apex Cursor? Apex Cursor is a new feature which came in Summer 24 release and it basically allows you to work efficiently with large amount of data. So when dealing with a large amount of data, we already have an option called Batch Apex where we write SQL query. An SQL query in Batch Apex is basically returns the entire dataset at once, while the cursor basically retrieves the entire dataset in a manageable chunk. So basically, if you have a large dataset, what Apex Cursor will do, it will break the entire dataset into multiple manageable chunks and then process those chunks individually. And this is a type of flexibility that Apex Cursor is introducing. And because of this flexibility, it is much easier to handle large amount of data and process this large amount of data more quickly, more efficiently. So let's understand the different advantages. Definitely, the first advantage is the reduced memory usage, like where the large SQL queries can return a massive data set, which will overload your memory, where the cursor will do from the entire large data set, cursor will break the data set into multiple manageable chunks and process those manageable chunks. So your pressure on the memory will be less. And that is the way it actually frees up the resources and improve the overall system performance. So that's definitely one biggest advantage using the Apex Cursor. The next advantage is basically the faster processing. By faster processing means here again the same thing. Instead of processing the entire data set, Apex Cursor again breaks into multiple manageable chunks and processes those chunks individually. So instead of processing the entire data set, processing individual manageable chunks, it is much easier and which improves the processing time. That's why it's called faster processing. Transaction boundaries is another advantage. Basically, Cursor operates within a single transaction. This means like you can, as a developer, you can write your Apex Cursor to process large amount of data without worrying about my job will exceed the transaction limit and all this thing. Basically, it works on the single transaction. And the fourth one, which is definitely a very important thing that we need to understand, it's basically the forward and the backward navigation. With Apex Cursor, you have the option to go forward and go backward. In Batch Apex, you have only option to go forward. You cannot go backward. But with Apex Cursor, you have the option to go forward and go backward, and which gives a huge flexibility to manipulate data in a more effective way. Okay, so the things that we need to know, how we can create a Apex Cursor. Cursor is created when an SQL query is executed with the database.getCursor or database.getCursor with binds call. These are the two methods which will be used to create the cursor. Second, when the cursor is created, how can I fetch the data? So when a cursor.fetch, it's a method which takes two parameters. One is the position, which is the integer value, and another is a count. And this method is basically invoked with an offset position. Start from this position and then get me this much amount of data. So position is basically your starting point. If you think in this way, like it's a pointer where my position will start, and count is basically from this point, give me this much of data. And this much of data is basically my manageable chunk, which I will process. So maximum number of rows per cursor is 50 million, regardless of the operation, whether it's a synchronous or asynchronous operation. Then number of rows. To get the number of cursor rows returned from the SQL query, the method is cursor.getNumRecords. And the fourth one is exception. So let's understand the different type of exceptions that are coming up along with Apex Cursor. So there are basically two types of system exception. One is called fatal cursor exception and one is called transient cursor exception. So any transaction which fails with the exception called system.transient cursor exception will be retried. Whereas if the exception is fatal cursor exception, that transaction will not be retried. So that's the difference between these two types of exceptions. With that, let's understand different type of limits. Maximum number of rows per cursor is 50 million, irrespective of whether it's a synchronous or asynchronous operation. Maximum number of fetch calls per transaction is 10. Maximum number of cursors per day is basically 10,000. And maximum number of rows per day is basically 100 million. So these are the limits, or these are the cursor limits that we need to keep in mind. So basically, you don't need to remember anything when you are developing the Apex cursor. Just refer the Salesforce developer note, and all these cursor limits will be updated. And it's a very good practice also to always refer the Salesforce documentation, because they keep on updating each release. Salesforce bring new features, new limits, new exceptions, right? So it's always better that you refer the Salesforce developer documentation so that you came to know all the updated information about a feature. Okay, so let's understand a code snippet. So what you can see in the screen is basically an implementation of the Apex cursor. So first thing is that I've written a class where I implement a queueable interface. And then here is basically where I'm creating the location. And here is basically the cursor. And locator is basically a type of database.cursor. The way to create a cursor is calling the database.getCursor method. And this is the SQL query that I'm writing. Basically, the query is telling, give me all contacts where the last activity date falls between the last 400 days. So give me all the contacts from my org. And this is a SQL query. With that SQL query, I'm creating a cursor. And this is a position, this is an integer value. I'm giving the position value as 0 so that it can start from the very first record. Now execute is a method which we need to overwrite. In the execute method, the first thing that I'm doing is basically location.fetch from this entire dataset, how much record I want to fetch at a time. So I'm starting from 0, position value is 0. Starting from 0, I want to fetch 200 records. That's my manageable chunk which I want to process with Apex cursor. And then my position will become scope.size. Scope.size is basically 200. So basically, if you think in this way, first my pointer points to number 0. But the moment I execute this function called location.fetch, it basically fetched 200 records. So my position is now moved from 0 to 200. Once I have that, this is the scope which is having those 200 records. And I can perform all my business logic on those 200 records. But what it's telling is that if there is more than 200 records, how can I handle that? So here is that. If the position is basically locator.getNumberRecord, say that getNumberRecord is 500, right? So definitely position is 200, but this is 500. So 200 is less than 500. That means there are still some records left which I need to process. So in that case, I will queue the job, which is basically system.nqueueJob. And this, what it will do, it will queue the job and then it will come back here and then it will again take another 200 records from the remaining. So this is the way how Apex cursor is being used to break a huge amount of data set into manageable chunk and then process on those individual chunks. The advantage, as you can see here, if this position is basically your pointer, you can go forward by scope.size, or if you want to go backward, you also have the option to go back, because your location.fetch position, this will tell you from where I want to fetch the data. If you are in 200 position, you can go backward and let the pointer points to 100th record. So this is the advantage of Apex cursor. You can go forward, you can go backward. I hope you understand the logic of this code. Okay, let's go back to the presentation. With that, let's understand the differences between Apex cursor and batch Apex. As I told, with Apex cursor, you have the option to go backward and go forward, whereas in batch, you only have the option to go forward. You cannot go backward. And another difference I can say, cursor can seamlessly work on a chain of queueable jobs for complex data processing. Whereas batch job, they work typically as a standalone job, and chaining of the multiple batch jobs is very complex. So these are the differences between batch Apex and Apex cursor. And this is something that you can keep in mind. And that's all for today. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please hit the like icon, share this video with your friends so that they come to know about this new powerful feature and they can implement that in their own project. And finally, please subscribe to my channel so that you came to know about all my upcoming videos. I'll be publishing new contents about Salesforce, Google Cloud in coming days. So if you subscribe, you will be the first person to be notified when I publish a new video. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.